Dear students, welcome you all. In the last video, we have discussed about origin and evolution of Earth along with the formation of crust. In this video, we are discussing about three important aspects. The first one is origin and evolution of life. The second one, origin and evolution of man. And the third one, place of origin of the humans. Let us discuss one by one. The first one, origin and evolution of life. There are many theories regarding the origin of life on Earth. According to the most popular theory, about 700 million years ago, the basic chemicals in the Earth's atmosphere, hydrogen and carbon, somehow combined to form life in the water. The two chemicals, the first one hydrogen and another one carbon, somehow combined to form life in the water. This slowly evolved into primitive water plants. The combination of carbon and hydrogen led to evolvement of primitive water plants. They began to grow and occupy the shallow and warm seas. The water plants gradually adapted themselves and began to encroach onto the land. About 500 million years ago, protozoa originated in the water. Around 500 million years ago, protozoa originated in the water. It is considered to be the first form of animal life. Protozoa is considered as first form of animal life. Then, single cell beings, ekakoshajeevigalu, became multicellular, bahukoshajeevigalagi. Single cell beings became multicellular. The primitive life forms like photosynthetic bacteria released oxygen. Due to photosynthesis, oxygen was released. The release of oxygen into atmosphere led to formation of higher life. The higher life originated and evolved. The higher life or higher life forms includes water creatures. It means we seen emergence of water creatures, jalacharigalu. Later, insects and amphibians came into existence. Kitagalu mattu amphibians means ubhayavasigalu. The amphibians were capable of existing on land and water as well. After the amphibians, the reptiles appeared and some of the species among them adapted to become birds. The reptiles, sarisrupagalu, appear. And some of the species among them adapted to become birds. Not all the reptiles, few reptiles became birds. All these diversified life forms took about 400 million years to evolve. It took around 400 million years to evolve. The mammals evolved about 200 million years ago. Mammals means sastanigalu. The mammals evolved about 200 million years ago. The present mammals like horses, camels, dogs. Horse, camels, dogs, etc. originated around 50 million years ago. Only 50 million years ago, the present mammals like horses, camels, dogs, etc. were originated.
Many diverse species of life originated and thrived. Some among them became extinct when they were unable to adapt to the climate changes or dominance of other species. Due to the climatic changes or dominance of other species, many of them unable to adapt. For example, dinosaurs, which once were a dominant species on Earth, became extinct about 65 million years ago. For chronological order, it is very important. Around 65 million years ago, dinosaurs are disappeared. The evolution of man. The study of human evolution is complicated. It is very difficult. It involves many disciplines, including anthropology. Here, disciplines means subjects. It involves many subjects, including anthropology, Manava Sastra, primatology, archaeology, Puratattva Sastra, linguistics, Bhasha Sastra, then embryology. Embryology means Bhruna Sastra, and genetics. Genetics means the study of genes, Thali Vijnana Sastra. So, the study of human evolution includes many disciplines, including anthropology, primatology, archaeology, linguistics, embryology, and genetics. Discovery of human fossils. Fossils means paleolithicalo. Stone tools and cave paintings serve as evidence for the study of evolution. Discovery of human fossils, stone tools, and cave paintings serve as evidence for the study of evolution. Most of such fossils discovered are of extinct species, which provide evidence to the evolution of man, are usually secured by chance. The process of recovery of the fossils is a very painstaking and laborious task. Fossils are dated directly through chemical analysis. Chemical analysis means, for example, carbon-14 analysis. Fossils are dated directly through chemical analysis, are the sediments in which the fossils were buried are chemically analyzed for dating. Many unanswered questions are being understood with the unearthing of new data and development of science. Unanswered questions are being understood with the unearthing of new data and development of science. The theory of natural selection proposed by Darwin in his famous book, The Origin of Species. Charles Robert Darwin wrote a famous book called The Origin of Species in 1859. In this book, he explains about two important theories. The first one, the theory of natural selection, and second one, survival of fittest. The theory of natural selection and a theory called survival of fittest can be seen as evidences to the evolution and extinction of different species. The reconstruction of human history becomes very difficult as the sources are very ancient, most of the times running into thousands of years. In this picture or slide shows skeletons of various apes along with that of the human. We can observe that there are close similarities among the humans and other apes. The similarities are evidences to the fact that the man and the apes had a common origin. Skeletons of gibbon, human, chimpanzees, gorilla, and orangutan are shown here. We see the similarities among these skeletons. In this figure, our slide shows the skulls of gorilla and various human species of different time periods. Notice the similarities and differences in the brain case, jaws, and the teeth, skulls and skeletons. The similarities are evidences to the fact that different species, including man and gorillas, are from the same origin. The differences shows The evolution of the skull in different human species at different periods of time. In this picture, you can easily find the differences between brain case, jaws and the teeth, skulls and skeletons. Let us see the family tree of extant species. The ancestral species of all the present humans, chimpanzees and bonobos, gorillas, orangutans and gibbons belong to the superfamily Hominidae. They are classified as primates. They branched out of the mammals about 36 million years ago. All the species belonging to the Hominidae superfamily are called hominoids. The superfamily Hominidae branched into hominid and helobitid families. The species of the respective families are called hominids and hylobatids. The hominids, that is humans, chimpanzees and bonobos, gorillas and orangutans, diverged away from the hylobatid, that is gibbons. The gibbons are separated from superfamily. The Hominidae family branched into hominine or homininae and pongine subfamilies. So the superfamily divided into subfamilies. Here the orangutans diverged from hominin family. The homininae subfamily branched into homininae and gorillinae. Again, the subfamily called homininae branched into homininae and gorillinae tribes. So the subfamily separated into tribes. So gorillinae and homininae were separated as tribes. The humans and chimpanzees and bonobos branched away from the gorillas. Here the gorillas are separated from human family. The homininae tribe branched into genus Homo and genus Pan. Again, the homininae tribe is branched or divided into genus. Two genus were created, one is Homo and another one is genus Pan. That is, the ancestral human species branched away from the chimpanzees and the bonobos. So here, the bonobos and chimpanzees are separated from homininae tribe as separate genus, and also man or human is separated from genus Pan as genus Homo. Hence, the chimpanzees and bonobos are the closest relatives of the humans. For examination point of view, too much question is there. The closest relatives of man. Chimpanzees and the bonobos are the closest relatives of the humans. As I stated earlier, the mammals are separated about 36 million years ago. From primates to genus Homo, it took more than 30 million years. The emergence of genus Homo brought human-like creatures on the Earth's surface about 5.6 million years ago. The Homo existed or came into existence 5.6 million years ago. 5.6 million years ago, the genus Homo came into existence. Next one, place of origin of the humans. The place of origin of the humans or modern man is a much debated issue. The place of the origin of the humans are much debated issue. There are two divergent theories. The first one, the replacement or African origin theory. The replacement or African origin theory. The second one, the regional continuity theory. The regional continuity theory. Let us see one by one. The first one, the replacement or African origin theory. According to this theory, the modern human species evolved from the archaic species in Africa. Archaic species, Arambika Jiva Jantukolo. According to this theory, the archaic species emerged in Africa only. Africa, with its nurturing tropical climate, consisting of strong wet and dry seasons provided an optimum environment for the emergence of modern human species. It provided an optimum environment for the emergence of modern human species. Some of them migrated to the different regions of the world, migrated to other areas of the world at different points of time. They replaced the earlier human-like species in those regions. They replaced the earlier human-like species in those regions. The discovery of fossils of the early human species in Africa, as shown in this slide. The discovery of fossils of the early human species in Africa and the genetical and anatomical homogeneity among the modern humans in all parts of the world are evidence for this theory. In this way, according to this theory, the modern man or humans are emerged only in Africa. Second one, the regional continuity theory. The regional continuity theory. According to this theory, the evolution of different human species from the earlier species occurred in all regions of the world. According to this theory, the evolution of different human species from the earlier species occurred in all regions of the world. Not only in Africa, the human evolution was took place in all other parts of the world. It occurred in Europe and Asia also as it occurred in Africa. So it occurred in Europe, Asia and Africa. The evolution proceeded at different rates at different regions. This evolution was took place in different rates at different regions. The dissimilarities among the human populations in different regions. Dissimilarities are differences among the human populations in different regions of the world serve as an evidence to this theory. These are the two important theories regarding the place of origin of the humans. Here I stop my explanations regarding the origin and evolution of man and also the place of origin of the humans. In the next video, I will explain about the factors responsible for human evolution. Thank you.